Jonas. Bass and stills in the building, flash the camera. I'ma drop the hammer. Things done changed and hip hop sizzle and Bobby out the slammer. Hip hop start on the East Coast, then it move west now down to Bama. I'ma bring it back to New York, roll those then throw your hands up. Pass me a cup of the in the club with the juice in the get bent out. Then I'ma slide with a to my ride and head up to my penthouse. Oh, I'm not trying to take it slow. Working hard, taking dough. Open the 24, we striving for that goal.
I'll stop it.
Changing climates and replacing humans and fracking soils while bulldozing forests, but they can't defeat us, they could not destroy us.
Are we dreaming the same dream of money, guns, and gasoline?
For the average team, CFOs are after cream, GMOs extracting genes with everyone on my TV.
Thank you. everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. The Lions continue to move through the season and want to find a way to secure win number 3 on the year. It's the Redskins going up against the Lions. With that, let's head up to Detroit as we say hello to our guys, Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
All right, Larry, first opened in 2002. There's a look inside Ford Field here in downtown Detroit. Today, we've got a matchup here in pivotal Week 7 between the Washington Redskins and the Detroit Lions. They come out with one back and 3 tight ends. This is Hightower. Nowhere to go that time. Might have gotten a yard up to the 25. Starting 11 here for the offense. It's going to take some snaps here in a second. Wide receiver Pierre Garçon, always been a very good force in this league.
I agree with you totally on that. Even as a youngster, played with a fury, played with force, continues to do that now as a veteran and knows how to mentor the younger guys.
Second down, Cousins. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. And now the Lions' defensive starters.
DeAndre Levy is one of those linebackers who makes everyone around him better when he's on the field.
An early tough test on the opening drive. This is 3rd and 8. They go play action. Cousins. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Brandon Copeland in there to drop it for a loss of 10. And it'll be 4th and long. Now on 4th down, the 2014 NFL leader as a rookie in yards per punt, Tress Way, on to kick it. Pulled in at the 24. Nice job on the return there, 16 yards, and the Lions will take over. Down. The completion good. This is Eric Ebron. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught, and you don't give up much run after the catch.
On 2nd down, here's Stafford. Out to the flat for Reddick. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
Now a 1st down throw, Stafford. It's brought in left side by Tate. Give him a couple on the catch at 2nd and 8. We get a look now at the offensive starting unit for the Detroit Lions, and one big target they have at tight end is Eric Ebron.
And they are ready for him to fulfill his promise because he was drafted to be a game breaker. Big target, guy who could block at the line of scrimmage, but really get downfield and make plays against defenders, overmatch them. They haven't seen enough of that yet. They want to come to the front in 2016.
And here is the Redskin defense.
Ryan Kerrigan is an example of bringing the best of you from college to the NFL and remaking your game. Terrific guy causing fumbles at Purdue, has done the exact same thing in the NFL, then lost weight and became an absolute terror rushing the passer.
It's caught, Jones. And he's going to have the 1st down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the 1st down. And that's what he just did.
And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Throwing is Stafford. The left side completion to Jones. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs. A lot of attention paid this week in practice to red zone offense. The coach was optimistic about how it went. We'll see. From the red zone now, Stafford looking for someone to throw to. Now he's flushed out left. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. Give him 8 on the play, and it's a second down.
Now that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable second and short.
Throw on second down to Stafford. He's got his man. It's caught for a Lion touchdown. Eric Ebron, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Lions are going to take a first quarter lead. It's up, it's good, and the Lions lead 7-0. After the touchdown, out is Prater to kick. That'll be taken in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20. A look at Washington as they come onto the field. And on the first drive, 3 and out. And I know that these are professional athletes, but I would imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the beginning of a game still, don't you?
Those don't ever go away. And typically what I've heard from guys and what I remember from playing, if you don't have nerves at the start of a game, it's not going to be a great day for you. You're not really ready to play. So finding a way to harness those nerves and not let them affect you in a negative way, that's what all the guys are looking for.
Calling no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
After watching that play and result, I go back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator, Brandon, before the game and said, how are you going to move the ball running it against the number one defense? He gave us no indication, didn't tip his hand at all, so we have to see how this unfolds as this game moves along.
It's hauled in by Brandon Cooks. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains.
They hit that crossing route really well. Excellent timing, puts it right on him, and he keeps running.
Yeah, turned it upfield for good yardage. A first down throw for Cousins. It's brought in by Jamison Crowder. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. And a nice little pass and catch there on the corner route.
Set up very well by the receiver with a head and shoulder fake inside before he comes back downhill to his quarterback.
They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. First down, here's Cousins. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. Back live, Charles Davis to my right. I'm Brandon Gauden. It's Redskin football to begin quarter number 2. They're looking at a second and short yardage to start things out. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. 2 yards on the pickup there, but it's enough to give him a new set of downs.
Second and one, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there. Pick up the first down.
All right, here we go. Boom, land it.
Cousins on first down. Got his target, Pierre Garçon. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. And some options here for the offense on second and 2.
Let's go!
Cousins now on second down. Caught on the right side, Reed. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains.
There's a completion to the tight end, and I think that we're looking at something out of central casting, frankly.
Absolutely. Size, the hands.
Speed. I mean, can flat out run. You put that whole package together, you light up the eyes of an offensive coordinator, don't you?
The backup, Rob Kelly, his first carry. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
Now Cousins, escaping the pressure right. 7 yards on the pickup there, and now they've got it 1st and goal.
Offensively, they liked their situation, so they tried to take a shot downfield, but no one was open, so it was tucking in run time, and he picks up a 1st down.
And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing out 2nd down.
Well, it's been the air game that's taken them down on this drive before they finally turned around and handed it off on the last play.
And now they're looking for the big boys to get him in the end zone. Couldn't do it there.
It'll be interesting to see. Offensive lines had to pass block a lot on this drive. Will they be able to revert and fire out and create some space in the run game?
And this seemingly endless drive continues.
Here we go now. Boom, landed.
Time running out here on the play clock. They'll try to throw now. Cousins. Now a clash of bodies here, and it's intercepted. Darius Slay with a pick. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Here's the Detroit offense now as they head back out onto the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away. One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there. And they were.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Ryan Kerrigan in there to get him, and that's sack number 6 for him on the year. And the O-line will have to do a better job protecting here on 3rd down after that sack. They'll come out in the pistol. Stafford, he's got time in the pocket. Under pressure, they got him again. Chris Baker in there to drop him, and back-to-back sacks now bring up 4th and long. So on 4th down, here's Sam Martin to punt it away for Detroit. 2 minutes to play here in the 1st half. We'll come back to Ford Field after this. Now the 4th-year punter from Appalachian State, that's Sam Martin on to kick. He'll take it at the 42. Only 29 yards on the punt there. Definitely not his best. And the Redskins will have a short field here as they take over 1st and 10. A look at Washington as they come onto the field. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told him, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football, and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
Over the middle, DeGarcon. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. And this time they go underneath for a simple pitch and catch.
And not only do you get the pitch and catch, Brandon, but you're able to keep the receiver moving when you hit him with the drag route.
On first and 10, Cousins. Flushed out right. 6 yards on the pickup, and it'll make it a second down.
Well, he did a nice job keeping his eyes downfield, waiting for someone to get open. But once the pressure forced his eyes down to see the rush, it was time to make a break for it.
And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. A give. This is Kelly. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Washington. A great play there. His second touchdown on the season. And the Redskins are an extra point away from tying this thing up. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Lions offense, they get ready to head back onto the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
And he's got it. What a catch on the sideline. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Stafford on first down. Over the middle, complete to Tate. The completion good for three, and it's second down. And now they're in the hurry up. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Here's Stafford now on second down. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. He was trying to find Marvin Jones that time. And now it's third down.
Everything looked right on that play except the conclusion. He dropped it, an in route, going into a little bit of traffic. Maybe in the back of his mind, he was wondering where the hit was going to come from.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. Stafford, and he'll be out of bounds as he gets this down about the 21 or 22. Thought he may have gotten away with one there, but the ref caught him, and it's holding. Fresh set of downs here. Now a play fake here on first down. And incomplete. He dropped it in the end zone. Eric Ebron, the big tight end, his intended target. And that'll bring up second down.
After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will absolutely break your heart. They had everything they wanted. Just unable to complete it in the end zone, a big time drop.
On second and 10, Stafford finding time. And that will be caught, but out of the end zone, says the field judge. It's ruled incomplete.
We know all the receivers go through those tiptoe drills, right? Trying to get their feet down in bounds. But a lot of the times, what we don't talk about is when they're up in the air and they catch the ball. You ever notice how they're reaching back with their feet? Not just straight down, but back, because they're trying to create enough distance to make sure their feet are in bounds. They weren't able to get it done on that one, though.
So they kick it through to take the lead. There is a little bit of time left, though, here in the second quarter.
And while they're concerned about not giving up a big return or giving up points themselves going into the half, how good do they feel, though, putting points on the board themselves right near the end of the first half?
And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. We have hit halftime. Still two more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
It's in the game.
So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Lions offense now with a football first here to begin quarter number three. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies. Try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
We'll see if they do just that. It goes as a pickup of 23. And it's good enough for a Detroit first down. So the offense has it first and 10. They go play action here on first down. And he's going to be out of bounds, but able to take it inside the 40-yard line. It's a gain of 14 there, and it'll be first down Detroit.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case the feet, doing a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
Here's Stafford. It's brought in left side by Tate. That catch good for five. It's third down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
So third and five, defensively expecting pass. They've got six DBs out there. To the air again, Stafford. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down. Now it's Matt Prater on for the Lion field goal try. From the left hash, it's an even 50-yard attempt. That's running out of steam, and it won't get there. He left it just short. No good. And this score will stay right where it is.
Well, this winds up an empty possession. Everything looked okay. He just never got the ball on target. And knowing him, he'll be disappointed with that effort.
On the carry, it's Hightower. So from the 40 to the 45, five-yard run.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front, because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
5 yards left for the offense. It's second down. Second down, Cousins throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. He was looking for Jamison Crowder there, and it's third and five. So third and five, third and medium here. They'll come out in the pistol. In motion, the tight end Reed. Throwing his Cousins. Crowder's got it over the middle. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet. Get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. He gets this away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the sidelines. And this will be out of bounds at the what here? The 12-yard line. And Detroit getting set to go now. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Closer.
Yeah, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held them to a gain of two. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and eight. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
That was a classic example of trying to run with the ball without securing the catch. He was thinking about those rack yards instead of making the catch first and then taking off.
And if they want to keep this drive alive, they'll need 8 yards here on third down. They'll put two receivers left, two to the right. Throwing on third down, Stafford. And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up fourth. Here's Sam Martin now, standing about a yard deep in his own end zone. And taken at the 46. 21 yards. Well done on the return. And this offense, they're going to have excellent field position. They take over with a first and 10 on the short side of the field. And a great spot to start this drive from here.
Let's go! 3-19!
They go play action. Cousins. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. A gain of four on the play. And that'll bring up second down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. Cousins now on second down. Complete to the right. This is Garcon. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
They run with Hightower. And he takes it down to the 13 and picks up the first. They get five out of that one, and it moves the chains.
On third down, that's a good job of situational football and understanding where the first down marker was and getting there.
And the offense lining up first and 10. They go play action here on first down. And a big loss here as he's taken down. It's the first time Pro Bowler from a year ago, Ziggy Ansah, in there to bury him for a loss of 11. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. It's a five receiver set, three to the left, two to the right. Now a second down throw for Cousins. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Brandon Cooks, the receiver he was going after. And it's third down.
When everything is in sync on defense, that means everyone's communicating really well. And sometimes it's nonverbal. They just know that when a receiver's in one spot, this person may have him. And he's in another spot, the next defender may have him. And they've squeezed the passing lanes down to where it's so difficult to find an open area to deliver the football. They've made it tough on them all game long. This has been a really nice day for the defense. They've made it so difficult to find open receivers because they're able to squeeze the passing lanes down. A lot of what they're doing is communicating. Receivers in one area, receivers in another area. They're almost what they call passing them off from one defender to the next, even in zone defenses, and making it very hard to find an open spot for the quarterback to deliver the ball.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. So here come the Lions now. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
The evaluation process in today's NFL does not take into account as much bulk as it does speed, and that's what we're seeing with the linebacker position. Those guys that can run, they can play at any spot because they can make plays on the opposite side of the line of scrimmage.
And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it.
When defenses get to the quarterback that quickly, a lot of times it's called a jailbreak. It wasn't quite that fast, but fast enough that he had no time to look downfield and set himself to throw the ball, and as he tried to do that, he was hit and it forced an incompletion.
Stafford, he's got time, and he can't quite pick it. No interceptions so far. That probably should have been their first, but at least it's fourth down.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum, big play, right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense that that fell harmlessly to the ground. Just a 30-yard punt that time. And this offense takes over in great shape right at the 50, first and 10. A look at Washington as they come onto the field. And after the field goal last time, see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them want it to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
Back now at Ford Field. All even as we get ready to start the fourth. Here on first down, rolling to his left, and he's going to drop this off to his fullback. It's an 8-yard pickup, and it'll be second down.
It's interesting because when I'm watching college football and I'm evaluating guys for the draft now, my list of fullbacks, pure fullbacks, it's a very short list. I'm probably evaluating more punters and kickers now than I am fullbacks, but doesn't matter what you call the position. It's who you put there, and there we saw completion.
Going to give this time to the tailback, and nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a third and two. And they're just a couple of yards shy of a first down here on third down. They go again with Hightower. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a fourth down. So the field goal unit is on the field, as this is a big spot right here. This to break our fourth quarter tie. And Hopkins' kick is good. And they will take the lead at 13-10. So the drive here ends with a field goal, and that does give them the lead, but this one is still a long ways from over.
And you love to be able to look up at the scoreboard and see that you're out in front, but then you take one look across the field and see that offense is raring to come back out, and you think, I don't know that field goals are going to be enough to get us home.
And Detroit getting set to go now, and they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Ebron with it over the middle, and they're able to get this one across the 35.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the ball, as we just saw there.
Back to throw, Stafford. Caught on the right side by Jones. 4 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it a second down.
If you're running out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tap and foot dragging, picking it up and making sure it was a catch.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. 7 yards there. Good enough to move the sticks.
That's a good, nice, crisp run for a first down. I wonder if the defense might have been loosened up a little bit, maybe anticipating a pass instead of the run that they got.
Stafford on first down. Out to the flat for Reddick. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and that'll make it second down. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. To throw on second down is Stafford. And this is caught on the sideline. But no, they'll say out of bounds. He caught it but was not in bounds. Incomplete.
That was a nice grab. Just couldn't get the feet down, right? You need that toe tap sequence there. Whatever size shoe he's wearing, probably need about a half size smaller to complete that one.
And here comes play number 6 on this drive. And defensively going with a dime set, 6 DBs on 3rd and 4. Stafford, and he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up 4th down. Here's Sam Martin now, as he'll punt it away for the 4th time today.
Partner, how many times have you heard it? Pressure creates diamonds, right? But it also bursts pipes. And on that one, that's what they got. They got after him, and he was fortunate just to get rid of it.
Yeah, he just had to chuck it away. Officially just 27 yards there on the punt. And the offense will come back onto the field for the 1st and 10. A look at Washington as they come onto the field. And they split the uprights last time for 3. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking, because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Yeah, run what you do best.
On the game.
Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. The best way to do it, touchdowns.
And the defense in desperate need of a stop. They have to get off the field and get the ball back to their offense if they want a chance. On 2nd down, Cousins again. Complete to the right. This is Garcon. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. And they'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for 3rd down.
When the hitch route is run really well, that jab step off the line of scrimmage by the receiver, which is designed to back up the defender and give him a little bit of space, all you want there, get that space, catch the football, and then make a move and pick up extra yardage. And that's exactly what he got done there.
Now a handoff here to his running back, and he gets it to the 34, good enough for the first. He needed a yard, that's what he got, and it's going to earn him a new set of downs. Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this.
Here we go now.
They go play action here on 1st down, and that'll be incomplete. Jordan Reed was the intended target, and it's 2nd down. Ten yards still left on 2nd down. Throwing here, Cousins. It's caught left side by Cooks. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. And a nice pitch and catch to pick up the reception against man coverage.
Both of them read how much yardage they needed, figured what they had to do, and were able to beat the man coverage for the completion.
They'll give it to him right up the gut. And there just continues to be nowhere to run. He's bottled up again at the line of scrimmage.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. Cousins. Throw complete right side to Cooks. Touchdown, Washington. Brandon Cooks, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Redskins are going to add on to their lead. And they're able to up the lead by one more. Following the touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away. Now the Lions offense, they get ready to head back out there. They might be thinking this is close to a lost cause here. Got to play it out. What do they need to do?
Well, they have a thought process in mind already, but they can't get ahead of themselves. They know that they need to score quickly.
Yeah, two-score game.
Onside kick and get the ball back and then score again, but they can't worry about the last 2 points.
Pressure from his right, and he goes down hard, flat on his back. Ryan Kerrigan in there to take him down, and the clock will roll. One receiver left, three to the right. Now it's Stafford. He's got his man, Jared Aberderis. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
When you're putting together a formula for winning defense, it's exactly what we're seeing in this game. Controlling the line of scrimmage, attacking, and changing everything so that now they're playing in the offense's backfield. They're playing an excellent game.
Well, Charles, it's great to win at home in the NFL. When you win on the road, it's a little extra special, isn't it?
It is, because let's face it, in most cases, you're not expected to go on the road and win in the National Football League. It just doesn't usually compute. So to get out there, get that done, and then head back to your city with one in the victory column, oh, that's a fantastic feeling.
So for Washington, they fall a game under 500 now at 3 up and 4 down. And they'll have another road date next week with the Cincinnati Bengals. Meanwhile, for Detroit, they dip to 2-5 now with the loss. And they'll look to regroup next week as they head to Houston to take on the Texans. So that's a wrap. For Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. With that, we say so long, everyone, from Ford Field.
killing it. Yeah, I've been hard in the paint, not a single assist. Yeah, I've been flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been now they with this. Yeah, I've been killing it. Yeah, I've been hard in the paint, not a single assist. Yeah, I've been flicking that wrist. Yeah, I've been now they with this. Yeah, I've been.